In this video, we will solve problem 1.10. Let's get started. In this problem, we have given a hill that is sloped downward at an angle theta with respect to horizontal, and a projectile of mass m is fired with speed v naught perpendicular to the hill. When it eventually lands on the hill, let its velocity make an angle beta with respect to the horizontal. We have to find out the dependence of beta on other quantities like theta, m, v naught, and g. Like in this problem, we don't have to derive the expression using projectile motion or kinematics. We can solve this question using dimensional analysis too. So we won't derive the formula for this question using kinematics. We just use dimensional analysis, and that will be more simpler than the deriving the expression. Okay, so let's get started. Let's say beta depends on some function of theta, like tan theta, sine theta, whatever it is, and some power of m to the power, let's say it is a to the power a, m to the power a, and b naught to the power b, and g to the power c. Using dimensional analysis, we know that beta is dimensionless, so its dimension is m0, l0, t0, and theta, f of theta, so theta is dimensionless, again f theta will be dimensionless, then m to the power a, b naught to the power b, g to the power c. If you use your common sense, then you can see this is a dimensionless term. So m in velocity and in gravity, there is no term for mass, so m won't be cancelled out, so a should be 0. And for velocity, it is l t minus 1, and for gravity it is l t minus 2, and let's write for mass 2, it is m. If you compare the right hand dimension and left hand dimension, then a is equal to 0, we found out, and b plus c should be 0, right? And time, that is minus b minus 2c, is equal to 0. So it will lead to a is equal to b is equal to c is equal to 0. You don't have to do these calculations, you can solve it directly by just using your common sense. But it suggests that b is depends on some function of theta. It can be a tan theta, or it can be tan 1 plus theta upon theta square, like this. And the correct formula we can find out using kinematics. We will see kinematics too. If you have questions like this, we should use dimensional analysis always. So that is the solution of this question.